welcome to worship on this Father's Day, and happy Father's Day to all who are fathers or grandfathers or uncles or those who are father figures in our lives. We especially thank the youth who will be leading us in worship today. Today's worship theme is hope. Hope, what keeps us going in a challenging time. Hope that fragile as soap bubble that can burst on contact. Hope that keeps us going through even the darkest of nights. Emily Dickinson wrote of hope, saying, "Hope is the thing with feathers that perches in the soul and sings the tune without the words and never stops at all." As we think about hope in the context of faith, we may hope in beautiful days like today. We may hope in the birds that sing. We may hope in the breeze that blows. We may hope in the flowers that grow. Our hope is also in the people of God who gather together in faith, even when we are at a distance. The youth have something to say about hope, and I look forward to what they offer as we participate in worship this morning.
Come, people of courage, offer your lives as a gift of service. Come, people who have uncertainties, drink deeply of God's gift of spirit. Come, people who weep in sorrow, for God is our comfort. Come, people everywhere, God is our hope and our strength, our source of joy. Listen to the words of the psalmist.
Psalm 146 from the Message. Hallelujah! O my soul, praise God. All my life long, I'll praise God, singing songs to my God as long as I live. Don't put your life in the hands of experts who know nothing of life, of salvation life. Mere humans don't have what it takes. When they die, their projects die with them. Instead, get hope from the God of Jacob. Put your hope in God and know of your blessing. God made sky and soil, sea and all the fish in it. He always does what he says. He defends the wronged. He feeds the hungry. God frees prisoners. He gives sight to the blind. He lifts up the fallen. God loves good people, protects strangers, takes the sides of orphans and widows, but makes short work of the wicked. God's in charge, always. Zion's God is God for good. Hallelujah. Please pray with me. God of hope, you give us what we need to wake up in the morning and to face whatever the day will bring. We hope in you, not an ordinary hope that we will get the grade we want or get into the school of our choice, things that depend on our work. Our hope in you isn't like hope for a nice day or a special gift, things that are dependent on weather patterns or someone else's choices. Our hope in you goes much deeper than that. We not only hope, but have confidence that you are with us wherever we are. As we gather in worship, we both hope and believe that you are already present. In Christ we pray.
Thank you. prophet Jeremiah repeatedly addresses the king of Judah that Jerusalem is going to be captured because the people have turned away from God. Although this tone is often negative, this warning about judgment is softened a bit by verses that promise that God has not and will not forget the people or the covenant God has made. Although there are bad times ahead, Jeremiah promises a future with hope. Jeremiah 29:11-13. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope. Then, when you call upon me and come and pray to me, I will hear you. When you search for me, you will find me if you seek me with all your heart. In Romans 5:1-8, Paul begins this section of his letter to the church in Rome by speaking of the endurance of faith, even in the midst of suffering, which leads to hope. Paul doesn't speak of suffering as something to be desired, but rather a fact of the life of faith. For Christ suffered and died for us even before we were believers. Paul argues, and that is proof of God's love and faithfulness. Romans 5:1-8. Therefore, we have been justified through faith. We have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith into this grace in which we now stand, and we boast in the hope of the glory of God. Not only so, but we also have glory in our sufferings, because we know that suffering produces perseverance, character, and hope. And hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. You see, at just the right time, when we were still powerless, Christ died for the ungodly. Very rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though for a good person, someone might possibly dare to die. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we are still sinners, Christ died for us.
Thank you.
hope during this pandemic is music. Music brings joy to everyone. I enjoy playing it on my instrument, singing, and listening to it. Happy Father's Day.
What brings me hope during this time, like Kara, is the joy of music. I'm involved in a variety of events and music events throughout the school and church. Jazz band, marching band, chorus, Ridgeway chorus, and Ridgeway brass, just to name a few. However, I am also reminded by Louis Armstrong's What a Wonderful World. In his song, one of his verses goes like this. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. Especially during this time, these words speak to me as I hope we can achieve peace across America and throughout the world.
Okay. Animals give me hope. Being able to see the love that animals bring people and people give to their animals gives me hope.
As well as all other fathers. When I hope for something, it is usually looking for something good or positive. We hope to have good health, our favorite sports team to win, or to have some lucky break. However, the theme of hope seems particularly fitting during this time. When COVID-19 first came about, we hoped that it would not affect our lives too much. Then, as it drew on, we hoped for a quick end to the virus and hoped to return to some sense of normalcy. Months passed. Until about two and a half weeks ago, when that hope took on a different form, and COVID-19 seemed to go into the background, there became a new hope for the world and U.S. particularly, in terms of hoping for changes and reforms, as well as a hope for peace. However, these kinds of hopes are not what the Bible speaks of. In the song, "In the Bulb There Is a Flower," we find a different version of hope. Cocoons turning into butterflies, winter turning into spring, and a dawn in every darkness, just to name a few. Each of these is an example of a promise which will be revealed in time to come. Paul is telling us, as Christians, we need to rejoice in our sufferings. Now, why would Paul be telling us to do this? It seems as if this is the exact opposite of what we would want to do in situations. Rejoicing in these situations seems silly and impossible. However, Paul tells us to rejoice because suffering produces in us the things God desires we have as Christians. Now, this doesn't mean we should look forward to suffering, or that it is something we should want to experience, but Paul tells us when we suffer, God is able to use it to produce good things. The first quality Paul writes about is endurance. Endurance means the ability to withstand hardship or adversity. This can relate to what has been going on in the world in the past few months. It has all been a question of, how much can we endure? How much longer will these things go on? However, through these sufferings, our faith does not lose its strength. In fact, our faith should be growing stronger during this time. When we are sad, or things don't seem to go well, we turn to God when there is nowhere else to go. When we seem to be suffering, we are drawn closer to God. Endurance is knowing that God is with us and can bring us hope in times of suffering. The next thing Paul writes about is that from character flows hope. Hope is the knowledge that things will get better. It may not seem this way at the current moment, and it seems as if there is no hope now. However, we have hope because the Holy Spirit has been given to us, and are assured that our faith in Christ is sufficient. The Holy Spirit brings us faith and keeps us in one true faith. It sees through our trials and our sufferings. The Holy Spirit reminds us that God is among us. His love for us is great, as Paul says in verse 8. God shows his love for us in that while we are still sinners, Christ died for us. Because Christ died for us, and nothing we suffer can steal what we have with God. God has forgiven us, meaning we now have peace with him. He walks with us every step of our lives. And because we have this peace with God, we have that peace in every situation, both happy and sad. So rejoice. Like our current sign outside church says, faith in God makes things possible, not easy. Through our trials and sufferings, God has given us hope to get through the tough times. He calls us to be by his side, where we can find endurance, character, hope, and comfort, which is poured out to all of us through the Holy Spirit. While suffering is not fun, but it is never final, as long as we have God with us, this is the certainty of Christianity, which is why we should rejoice. Through it all, we have hope, as difficult as it can be at times. Sometimes it seems impossible. For the service, my mother had the idea of blowing bubbles to catch and share hope. What seemed like a simple idea at the time was not so easy with the wind that blew, with the wind that blew and bubbles that floated out of reach or immediately popped. But maybe that is part of the challenging part of hope. It is when we are going through our most difficult times, and when hope is hardest to catch, and keep that we remember that God is the source of our hope and strength. We hold on to the promise of the prophet Jeremiah that God will give us a future with hope. Although we may struggle to hold on to what is familiar or chase after dreams as fragile as bubbles, we trust that God holds us and keeps us. May it be so.
You probably know me already, but I graduated this year, class of 2020, and in the fall I'm going to Penn State as an undecided major, so I'm very excited, and we'll see what the future holds. We are.
Ben, in celebration of your graduation from high school, we light this candle. Ben, I have known you since before you started kindergarten. And over the years, I have watched you grow up, and in your case, I have watched you grow up. I have witnessed your ability to think creatively, your humorous accents when reading scripture, your friendliness and smile. These are all qualities that will serve you well, in addition to the many gifts that you have been given. You're intelligent, you're musical, you're athletic. Use these gifts wisely. Use them in service to others. Use the gifts that we have tried to offer you as a congregation to strengthen you on your journey This has not been the senior year that you or any other graduates could ever have imagined or chosen. And yet I hope in this 2020, this year that many imagined would be a year of great vision, that there are still gifts and lessons to be learned. As you have come through this unusual senior year and graduation, and as you look toward Penn State, saying in your response that you'll see what the whole future holds, I trust that the future holds good things for you. You go with our prayers, with our support, with our eagerness to see how you continue to grow and develop. You will be receiving a gift from the congregation, a gift that is intended to support you on your journey, a reminder of faith that sustains you and shapes you, and that has shaped who we are as a congregation. Now, Ben, as God leads you, may you feel wisdom. May you find your calling. May you be surrounded by new opportunities that both challenge and confirm and comfort you as you pursue your dreams. May you be held in love. May you be held with wonder and excitement. May you know that you always have a place to return to, with people who love you and are rooting for you even now. We may not be Penn State, but we are your church family. Blessings of Christ be with you. Amen.
I invite you to look at the joys and concerns that have been shared during the week by email and what you are holding in your hearts at this time. Please pray with me. Lord Jesus, you have reached out to us in our distress and lifted us up. You give us new life, and we are grateful. For some of us, this has been a wonderful week, but for others, trials and troubles seem to crowd into their lives. We ask your loving presence with all your people, O Lord. Heal our wounded spirits. Restore a sense of joy in our lives. Today, we name in our hearts and with our voices those who are in need of your healing love. We thank you that you reach out to them, to all those whom we have named and for those whose names are in our hearts. Help us to be witnesses to the power of Jesus Christ to make those changes in our lives. Amen.
Thank you.
lost and weary, let us place our trust in the divine. We pray to find hope within our fear as we recognize our God is near. May we always look for help that is sent to us. Amen.